Reality TV is all about drama and awkwardness, and TLC's hit show 90 Day Fiance has definitely more than enough of both to offer. From uncomfortable family encounters to lack of cultural awareness, here are some bizarre scenes from 90 Day Fiance. Molly and Louis had a number of crazy fights, for example. When Louis accused Molly of having demons in her house, he was talking about her oriental Buddha figure around the house. And she responded by going completely nuts and ranting about how the love for the Lord is in her heart and how the pornography on his phone is the devil rather than her decorations. While this fight was pretty memorable, it took things even further during an argument that turned out to seal the end of their relationship. Following their time on 90 Day Fiancé, they had been fighting so much that Louis eventually locked himself in the guest room, but the fact that he blasted music in her house got Molly so upset that she decided to pick the lock on him. It seemed more like a mother talking to her child at first, but Molly then quickly displayed childish behavior by blocking the door and pushing Louis around until he decided to call the cops. Rather than speaking to her about the issues following the argument, Molly decided to take her daughter to her best friend's house, and when she came back the next day, Louis had packed up his stuff and left her house. Overcoming cultural differences can be quite challenging, and it was certainly not easy for Elizabeth and Andre either. American Elizabeth was used to doing her own thing and going out with her friends, for example, but Maldivian Andre felt like she shouldn't go out without him, seeing as if she was about to become his wife. In fact, as the man of the house, he felt like he was in a position to forbid her to do so, and he wasn't about to let her go to a club for her bachelorette party either. Viewers weren't the only ones who found the attitude disturbing. Elizabeth's friends and family were also quite worried about seeing her change so much and being so submissive to a man that they have never even met. Despite all of this, the couple still got married at the end of 90 Day Fiancé and welcomed their first child, a daughter, Eleanor, in January 2019. Mohammed and Danielle had so many moments that were uncomfortable to watch that it was hard to just pick one. Mohammed moves from Tunisia to Ohio to marry Danielle in season 2, but their relationship appeared to be rather one-sided, with Mohammed even refusing to kiss Danielle during the wedding ceremony. They eventually separated but were legally married when they appeared in season 1 of 90 Day Fiancé. Happily Ever After, during the tell-all episode at the end of the season, their cringe-worthy interactions reached an embarrassing climax when moderator Sean Robinson asked if there had been any intimacy between the two of them after their wedding and set the stage for what was probably the most awkward sex talk in TLC history. Mohammed replied that there had been issues claiming that Danielle would beg for sex, allegedly screaming, "I want my sex tonight," in front of her teenage kids and threatening to have him deported. Danielle hit back by claiming that Mohammed had told people that she smelled and had peed on him. The whole situation was made even more awkward by the fact that the other castmates were watching the conversation off stage and could be seen laughing in embarrassment and making faces upon hearing the allegations. Paul and Corrine didn't have the easiest start due to the fact they couldn't communicate very well because they didn't speak the same language. But Paul's bizarre behavior and his lack of understanding for Korean's culture, he straight up refused to learn Portuguese and often acted in a controlling manner because he mistrusted her. While not being upfront about his criminal past himself, pretty much everything about these two was cringeworthy, from Paul's preparation for the journey to Brazil to his strange swimming condom and the awkward marriage proposal. Yet, they shocked everyone by ultimately making it work against all odds and becoming parents of a baby boy named Pierre in March earlier this year. Pretty much from the moment her plane touched down in Las Vegas, Larissa made it quite clear that she was disappointed by pretty much everything that fiancé Colt had to offer her. She was disappointed by the size of her new home and didn't exactly jump with joy about the fact that she would have to live there with Colt and his mother either. Even making fun of the poor woman's furniture, or rather the lack thereof, and decorations, they had a lot of arguments, some of them so violent that police got involved. But what disturbed viewers most about the couple was probably Colt's strangely codependent relationship with his mother Debbie. The two shared a home and even a bank account, and as Larissa quite rightly pointed out, it seemed for the 33-year-old Colt to cut the umbilical cord with his mother. That's all we have for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to leave a comment, like, and subscribe to the channel.